Now, Elvira Sutrenich from the superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, from all the body, it will become to the right atrium, and from right atrium through the tricuspid valve, it go to the right ventricles, and it will be pumped by the right ventricles through the pulmonary artery to the circulation of the lung. It will be the oxygenated blood become oxygenated blood, and would be retained the oxygenated blood through the pulmonary veins to the left atrium, and from the left atrium through the mitral valve it go to the left ventricle, and it will be distributed all the body from the left ventricle through the pulmonary artery, through the aorta, through the aortic valve. This is a complete separation between two circulations. We have four valves in the heart. Three of them, they have three cusps, and only one have one cusp. A mitral valve only have two cusps. The aorta have three cusps. The pulmonary artery valve have three cusps, and tricuspid valve have three cusps. The valve between the atria and ventricle have chordae, and this chordae tendon with the papillary muscle connected them to the wall of the ventricles. And the aorta, and pulmonary, valve have no chordae or papillary muscles. Also, beside that, we have two coronary artery, two main vessels, left and right coronary. The right coronary artery represented about 60% are dominant artery, and left coronary artery represented 40% of the dominant artery of the myocardium. As we can see here in the photo, this is the pulmonary have a three cusp, and this is a chordae tendon, and this is a papillary muscle attached to the cusp of the valves. This is anterior view, as we can see it. This is how we can see the pulmonary valve and aortic valve, and both of them you can see the mitral valve with the chordae and tendon and papillary muscles, and with the tricuspid valve also we have a papillary muscle and chordae tendon attached to cusp. As we see here, the right coronary artery and left coronary artery. The right coronary artery are anterior to the aorta and to the pulmonary trunk, and left coronary are behind the left main pulmonary trunk. Immediately, the right coronary artery give an SA node. This is the main station of the making the pulse in the heart. This is a pacemaker of the heart. This is a take blood supply from the right coronary. And also we have the atrium to the atrial right atrium. And we have what we call a marginal right marginal artery, and the continuation of right coronary artery, it will be go to the posterior interventricular to meet left anterior descending artery. It will become to the communication to the right coronary artery. Left main coronary are very important one, which is the closure of this one, it lead to immediate death. After the origin of the left main coronary artery, it will be separated to two branches. One we call the circumflex, and the another one which we call the left anterior descending. And from the anterior descending artery, we have 5 to 7 diagonal artery that supply the septum of the left ventricles. And this is, it will be end LID, what we call anterior descending artery. It will be go to what we call it anterior interventricular to meet a posterior interventricular artery. The vein of the artery also, we have this artery as we show it, okay? And we have also the veins that supply of the myocardium. And the most important, we have the drainage of the greater cardiac vein and smaller cardiac vein to the coronary sinus, which is the very important sinus in the right atrium, behind the right atrium. There is a total separation of these circulation, as I mentioned before. And the surgery of the heart is depend on the which type of pathology, either have a congenital heart disease or acquired heart disease. Both of them maybe have either by doing an interventionist or by do an open surgery, Before of this, any part of the surgery, you should be reach a diagnosis, and the diagnosis of this one, it should be done by the physician, And after that, we need to have a teamwork to decide the type and time of the procedure we do it. The first heart done by the surgeon in 1940 in the first war time, there's a soldier have a hit a bullet in the heart, and the removal of that bullet at that time, it was a miracle. The first operation done to closure atrial septal defect, ASD correction, was in 1952, but the open heart is in general start in 1954. By the way, the first surgical procedure done in the Iraq, it is in 1960, done by a professor, Allah yarahma ustadna Zain, Omar Zain. ذاك الوقت احنا كنا the first center in the Middle East and in Arab country, we do an open heart surgery. This is by Yusuf al-Nu'man, the pioneer of the cardiac surgery in the Iraq. Allah yarahma. Before deciding to do a heart surgery, as I mentioned, which you should be take a history, either this is a rheumatic heart disease or not, it's a congenital or non-congenital. We took a family from the family history of a congenital one, if they have a cyanosis or acyanosis one. And doing this investigation, I think it is mentioned in the medical site by ECG and chest X-ray echo, treadmill, and ECG echo with treadmill and radioactive isotopes, a CT angio of the myocardium and thallium study, also an MRI. And also, before I do any surgery, you can do a cardiac catheterization or angiogram. Now, we have two types of the cardiac surgery. You should remember it very well. We have either closed heart surgery, mean the heart is still pumping, or we have an open heart surgery, mean pump off. This is when we do an open heart surgery, you should be the heart needed connected to the what we call the extracorporeal circulation, or what we call the cardiopulmonary bypass, cardiopulmonary. This is a machine that connected to the heart, it will be lead to the arrested of the heart. And when we do, it should be in heart in asystole and have no movement, and we can do a surgery to correct any anomalies in the heart, either it is a congenital or it is acquired one. The closed heart surgery now by the day, because of the interventionist, it is more common today. Our job, it will be reduced tremendously due to the cardiac intervention. Routinely, the mitral stenosis is redoed by closed valvotomy previously. By nowadays, they do it by cardiac interventions, by open prolonged valvotomy. Also, when we have a BDA, it will be a closure by the plaque. We do it previously. We do a surgery, what we call it, and a close heart surgery, and no need for a bypass machine. And coarctation of aorta also, we do it a surgery. Now they do it by the balloon and cardiac by the irritation of them, and they put a stent. And the cardiac surgeon always stand by when any interventionist, because any complication may occur during the interventionist, we should be interfere immediately to correct any complication occur by the cardiologist interventionist. Now there's also, beside of the surgeon, they have a robotic surgery. This is what we call hybrid combination between endoscopic and open by using a robotic surgery. And this is also, we have a non-invasive surgery for mitral and also for BDA co-architection. And now it is also we do an off pump and beating heart, what we call a cardio, yani coronary artery bypass graft. This is why also sometimes we do a closed heart surgery, what we call a palliative surgery for congenital heart disease. We will discuss it in the next lecture according to the what we have a problem in the congenital heart disease. In open heart surgery, the most major type of the heart surgery now presented about 75% to the 80% of the pathology. What we mean by the open heart surgery? Open heart surgery, should we put a patient in position of the supine and we put a below behind the scapula, and after complete aseptic technique, we do a sternotomy, median sternotomy. For cosmetics, sometimes we use submammillary, especially in female, yani if they need not show a scar in the front of the chest, we do submammillary incision. Now they have nearby they do by small incision, we can correct it. But routinely we can do a sternotomy, median sternotomy. When we open the skin, a subcutaneous, and after that we have the sternum and use a cautery to separate it, the periosteum of that. After that we do an electrical saw to cut the sternum in two-sided. After that we should be do a hemostasis. When we open the sternum, immediately we face it the thymus. The thymus, it will be atrophied in the adult and big in the children. By the time it will become atrophied, we remove the thymus, and after that we open the pericardium. When we open the pericardium in midline, we should be a stay suture of pericardium. We stay as any. We keep the pericardium and stasis in the wall of the sternum to exposure the heart. After that, we can identify the aorta, pulmonary artery, and we also inspected the disease of the heart. After that, we can do a bypass surgery. Bypass surgery now, as we see in the picture, this is in the behind the nipple, as we see, this is a submammillary, but this is a median sternotomy. This is what we call it electrical saw to cut the sternum. This is a spreader of the sternum, or what we call it a retractor, as you see, and you can exposure of the heart. You see the right ventricle in front of you, and this is a right atrium in the front of you, and there is a pulmonary in the front, and behind it there is aorta, and we have a left side of your view, you see the SVC, superior vena cava. It should be when a start of the cardiac bypass machine, you should be heparinize the patient. The heparinization of the patient, you should be give 3 milligram or 300 international unit per kg, and you should be reach LPT and PTT till 250 in a 400 second should be reached. This is to prevent any thrombosis or embolization of the blood during surgery of the open heart surgery. Always you should be check it in PTT. PTT should be above 250 second in a 400 second. Below it, it should be increase the doses of the heparin. And every time they check it in PTT during our procedure by anesthetist and by the perfusionist, he said, I should be give more doses of the heparin. I said, okay, you can deal with this. After that, we do a pursuit ring and the aorta for the aortic cannulation, and you should be have cannulation to the atrium. We do it in cannulation to the right atrium. This have either use one cannula or what you use, a double cannula. Double cannula mean either a single cannula, I put it only in the right atrium. A double cannula mean I should be put it from right atrium going through to the superior vena cava and other one go to the inferior vena cava. This is what we call it, total bypass, total bypass. Mean all the venous drainage of the body, it will be go to the machine. This is what we do it. And the correction of any right side problem of the heart, we use a total bypass, not a partial. Any pathology. Remember this, my dear student, you should be remember it. Any type of surgery on the right side, we should be do a total bypass. Mean all the drainage of the venous should be going to the machine. Any surgery of the left side, like a mitral valve, aortic, it is not need what we have, only one cannula. This is what we call a partial bypass. Left side, only one cannula, we call it partial bypass machine, any circulation. Here in the right side, what we call total bypass circulation. This is, you should be remember it very well. The machine of the extracorporeal circulation contains many things. First of all, we have oxygenator, it took the way of the lung, and we have a pump, it works like a heart, and we have a tube, and this is a tube represented the blood vessels and this. And also we have beside the vacuum have a heater exchange, either cooling or heating of the gas, and also we have a filtration. This is the machine that we connected the heart to the machine by two tubes or one tube from the right atrium. It go by the siphon procedure. And no need for suction. It will be immediately the blood coming to the venous reservoir. From the venous reservoir, it go to the oxygenator. We have many type of oxygenator. Either we have a membranous or bubble one. Membranous is more used in one day and today. Previously, we use a bubble one. Bubble one, it will be, yani take only 4 hours to do a surgery. While when we use a membranous one, we can use a long time of surgery, reach to the 24 hours if the procedure of surgery take this time. From the oxygenator, either we go the blood, it will be oxygenated, it go to the filtration. From filtration, we do a heater. Either when I do a surgery, it should be cooling the patient. According to the type of surgery, I start cool this patient. If it is a procedure like a small ISD, it take only 15 minutes to do it. I will be reduce the temperature to 32 because I will be need to rewarming of the patient. It take no time for me. But the procedure take a long time. I will be reduce the temperature of the body to 28%. When there is a procedure, it is needed to cardiac arrest completely. Maybe I raise the temperature to the 20 centigrade. This is according to the type of pathology and the type of surgery that I will do it. And after that, when I call this patient, we have a rural pump. This is, it will be push the blood to the aortic cannula, and from the aortic cannula, it will be distributed all the body. Below the aortic cannula, I put a cross clamp to prevent the blood come to the heart. I will be put it below distally to the aortic cannula. I put a clamp. Now, how I can keep the heart without any damage? First of all, by cooling. And beside that, we can put ice lashes on the top of the myocardium to reduce the temperature of the myocardium. And the most important, we put a cardioplegia. This is the tubes that you see it in the theater of open heart surgery. Heroic, you can't see yourself because it is a many camera and many tubes and many machines and many monitoring. there is in the side, and we have at least we have two assistant and one circulating nurse, and beside there is a assistant nurse beside the circulating nurse. This is how we put a cannulation here, the aortic cannulation here, a double cannulation for the venous drainage. This is how we can put it, sorry. This is the aortic cannula, and this is a venous cannulae. You can see this is a double venous cannulae go to the superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. This is what we have, a total bypass. This is how it will be appear, the machine. The venous drainage go to the venous reservoir by the gravity and will be heater, oxygenator, heater, or cooler of that one, and we have a ruler one go and supply the blood to the all the body through the aorta. After that, this is how we appear in the field, that when you open it. And the most important now, to keep heart in a proper way, you should be put a cardioplegia. What is a cardioplegia? Cardioplegia, it is hyperkalemic cold solution. And it is contain high concentration of potassium. Why you put it like this? This is lead to the make the heart in asystole, to stop the heart in asystole. يعني حتى يصير flabby heart. ليكون يعني stone the heart يكون stony like appearance. يعني لما أريد أشتغل على الهارت الفلوبي راخي الهارت حتى أقدر أشتغل لما أفتح الأتريوم. لما أفتح الأتريوم أقدر أوصل لل correction of the pathology, it is easy. بينما يكون stony heart يكون in systole one contraction, you can't do any surgery in this form of the heart. For always keep it in asystole and floppy heart. This is the most important. It is a cardioplegic. It is a cardioplegic. This is we put it, يعني distally to the aortic cross clamp. It will be go to the integrate to the left coronary sinus and right coronary sinus to supply the coronary artery. And if it is an obstruction in the coronary artery, we can go retrograde through the coronary sinus to supply cardioplegic. Many methods to do a cardioplegic solution insertion. This is not below your level. This is a postgraduate, we mentioned it. But for you, you should be know what is the cardioplegia. Cardioplegia, it is hyperkalemic cold solution. This is to preserve the myocardium through the aortic, through the coronary arteries, through the coronary arteries. So we have three things to co-protect the heart by cooling systematically to keep a low metabolization of the whole body. Second, by topical, put an ice lashes to keep the myocardium, and third one by cardioplegic hyperkalemic cold solution to keep circulation of the coronary artery to reach all part of the myocardium to prevent any damage from the heating. After the surgery, we should be close the chambers. It should be before that, you should be deaerated. Yeah, don't keep any drop of the air in the left atrium or the right atrium before we closure any incision of your atrium. Your atrium, you should be pull the heart. يعني you should be partially across the venous drainage to keep the heart filling by the vein, by the venous blood, by venous blood. And when we have filling the left atrium and right atrium by the blood, and make a deaeration, the most important deaeration. After that, you can remove the tubes of the vein side, the IVC or SVC, and lastly, when we all the reservoir of blood in the machine return back to the heart, we remove the aortic cannula. This is the procedure we do it in the open heart surgery. Now, another thing you should put it in your mind, in the cardiac surgery, this is what we call it, a risk of open heart surgery. What is the risk of the open heart surgery? Most important in any type of surgery, you face it, first of all, we have an infection. But we are completely sterilized in this theater, of the open heart surgery, completely isolation, but still there's a risk of the wound infection. Whom it will be affected? When the patient is immunocompromised, either diabetic or uremic patient, or the patient is so obese, and in case of the cabbage, coronary artery bypass graft, why it is occurred? This is when we use the left internal mammary artery and right internal mammary artery, either lima or rima. This is when you use it both of them, there is a still possibility increase of the wound infection. The worst of that one, the wound infection, it is external dehiscence. This is so risky. هذا يعتبر مثل كابوس على الجراح القلب لما يكون عنده external dehiscence. This is difficult to deal it. It should be an increase in this complication, maybe increase the mortality rate more than 25% إلى 50% when you have a external dehiscence due to the repeated infection one. Second one, maybe you have a heart attack or stroke. So always when we mention with the patient about open heart surgery, you should be have a concept. You should give this patient a percentage. Maybe you have a possibility 5% you have a wound infection. Maybe you have 1.5% you have a stroke, CVA, maybe you have. And maybe you have a renal problem, it will be a renal failure about 1%. And maybe you have a loss of memory, what we call it woozyness maybe occur in 0.5%. And maybe you have an irregular heartbeat post-operative. So always in post-operative, when you have any problem, you put a temporary pacemaker, we put it at least we keep it for 24 hours to 72 hours. Because immediately when we finish this patient, we transfer this patient to the intensive care unit with the intubation, still the patient on the ventricular assistant device, على ventilator يبقى المريض, till he retain a powerful, there is no drainage from the tubes, because we put three tubes or two tubes post-operative, one in the pericardial sac, one in the sternum, below the sternum. And when we have accidentally opened the pleura, maybe you put it in the left pleura or right pleura. Maybe you have three or two or four sometimes. If it is a two pleura, it isn't open, we can put a two chest tube in the right thoracic cavity and the left thoracic cavity beside the pericardial drainage and substernal drainage. This is always when the patient is completely recovered from the trauma of the anesthesia, trauma of the surgery, then we extubated this patient from the ventilator, start weaning, and keep this patient in the intensive care unit for 3 days. And after that, we transfer this patient to the ward, stay in the ward for 3 to 4 days. In 7 days, he can go to the home. Also, we have a blood clot because of low dose of heparinization, and we have, you should be corrected if you have hemorrhage, you should be corrected in heparin by protamine sulfate. We give a 1 milligram for each 100 international unit to antidote of the heparin to prevent this. Always we need to check, maybe you need this patient a fresh frozen plasma, or maybe you need a platelet to stop any bleeding. Breathing difficulty because of the pain of the wound, because of the tubes, because the patient have a central line, he have يعني فوليس كاثيتر, he have يعني nasogastric tube, he have an arterial line, many lines this patient he have, this is all يعني it will be painful, but يعني each step we will remove one, يعني nasogastric we remove it, after that the arterial line you remove it, we remove it, central venous line we remove it, lastly الفوليس كاثيتر we remove it after that. Okay. Maybe you have a pneumonia, because of the difficulty, in the breathing and pain. The patient is not cooperated with the surgeon. He said you should be done an exercise, a breathing exercise. You should be do it, and chest physiotherapy, you should be do it. The patient may be here because of the pain, or he afraid from the يعني distance of the wound. He keep his breathing and lead to the atelectasis, later on lead to the pneumonia. الopen heart, you should be يعني feel gradually improved. Take this 6 weeks, يعني not يعني it mentioned to the patient it will become correctly immediately, become a normal patient, in a normal person. And should be take a time at least 6 weeks before start feeling of the better, and to 6 months he feel a full benefit of the surgery. يعني تقول للمريضة خلال 6 أسابيع يعني تتحسن الأمور مالتك, خلال 6 شهور ترجع إلى وضعيتك الطبيعية, يعني تكون العملية مالتك مشت بالشكل المضبوط. Especially, you should be mentioned, when this patient we do a graft for him, يعني coronary artery bypass graft, this is maybe it take many, many years, maybe clotted, maybe lead to occlusion of this graft again, yeah, because of the processing of the life, still atherosclerosis occur and this donated graft we put it. Maybe you have another problem of the coronary artery in the future. You should be also inform the patient it is not a long life any patency of this graft. There is also, you should be يعني encourage the patient for eating a healthy diet. يعني يقول له بطل الهاي هاي هاي كالوري اوف ذا sugars, الليبيد, you should be reduce it and cut off of the high salt and fat, leading to more active life. يعني the most important now it is the exercise. The best exercise now in the world it is the walking. At least the patient, he should be walk half an hour per day, mean more than 10,000 steps per day. This is, it will be lead to a good lifestyle for you. Stop smoking and controlling of the high blood pressure and high cholesterol. After surgery, but after the surgery, when we do it, you should be complete everything. I always, put it always this, what we call it, yesterday is a history, tomorrow is a mystery, today is a gift. That's why we call it is a present. Happiness is not an absence of the problems, but ability to deal with them. Thank you for your listening. There.